The celestial sphere. The celestial sphere is a way of astronomers picturing the sky from an earth-based point of view. So let's draw our little observer, little stick man here. And since our person is standing on the ground, I'm going to represent the ground around him. Now, if we could extend that ground all the way out to where you don't see land anymore, that boundary is called the horizon. So the horizon is defined as the point where land meets sky. Now, for our purposes, we're going to put in some compass directions, and we're going to have south in front here, so north is in the back. And from this perspective, then, we're going to have east to the right and west to the left. As Earth rotates, that is going to change what's on the horizon. So when we say we see stars rising in the east, what's actually happening is the eastern horizon is dipping lower and allowing us to see new stars. And similarly, when we see stars set in the west, it's because our western horizon is rising up and blocking out those stars. So Earth's motion is affecting what we see on the horizon. Your location on Earth will also affect this. If you travel farther south, then new stars will appear on your southern horizon. Or if you travel farther north, objects on the northern horizon will get higher. If we think about what's above us in the sky, then we draw this dome over our person. And up at the top is another of our sky markers, and this is called the zenith. And this is defined as the point straight overhead. And like the horizon, Earth's motions are going to affect what's on the zenith. So as Earth rotates, different objects will be on the zenith. And depending on where you are on the Earth, you'll have different objects on your zenith. Now let's connect a line starting at our northern horizon, going up to the zenith, and then coming down to our southern horizon. It's not drawn terribly well, but there you go. This is called the meridian. And the meridian is what separates the eastern and western sky. And as objects rise and set, when they are on the meridian is when they are going to be at their highest point in the sky. When you tell time and you designate the time as AM or PM, those are references to the meridian. AM is when the sun is in the sky before the meridian. AM stands for anti-meridian, A-N-T-E, meridian, which means before the meridian. PM is post-meridian, or after the meridian. So PM is when the sun has passed the meridian. And local noon is when the sun is on the meridian. The next object that we're going to look at in our celestial sphere, our point in the sky, is very dependent on your location north and south. I'm going to draw a little plus sign right here. And this represents what's called the North Celestial Pole. And this is the point above the North Pole. Now, where I've drawn it is for relatively mid-northern latitudes. How high up the North Celestial Pole is depends on how far north you are. The farther north you live, the higher up the North Celestial Pole is. The farther south you live, the lower it is. If you lived at the North Pole, it would be straight overhead. Now, if you watched the stars over the course of a night, you would notice that some stars are going to rise and set. Some stars, though, closer to the North Celestial Pole, are going to circle around. And if you look straight at the North Celestial Pole, you'll notice one star that doesn't really move much, and that's the North Star. It's also known as Polaris. Now, a lot of people think the North Star is the brightest star in the night sky. It is not. It is about 50th in brightness. What makes the North Star special is the fact that it does not move. So, everything else in the sky during the night is going to move, either a little bit if it's in here close to the North Celestial Pole, or quite a lot if it's much farther out. But the North Star doesn't really move. So if you need help in navigating and figuring out where you are, you want a fixed point. And that's why the North Star is so important. These circles showing the star paths, if I keep going further and further out from my little North Celestial Pole, I'll eventually find a path of stars that just skirt above the northern horizon, but still stay up. So this circle and all the stars inside of it represent a part of the sky where the stars never set. And that is called the circumpolar zone. So this is defined as where the stars never set. And since your location on Earth depends on how high the North Celestial Pole is, and the North Celestial Pole is going to be at the center of your circumpolar zone, how big the circumpolar zone is will depend upon your location on Earth. So let's look at two special cases. First case is going to be at the equator. So here's our little person and our horizon and our celestial sphere. At the equator, the North Celestial Pole is going to be exactly at the northern horizon. And we didn't talk about it, but there is also a South Celestial Pole. Northern Hemisphere people don't get to see this, but this would be exactly at the southern horizon. And if you went out and watched the stars over the course of the night, you would find that all the stars are going to rise and set. So at the equator, all stars rise and set. Now, the other special case is going to be at the North Pole. We could also do this for the South Pole, but we're very biased towards the Northern Hemisphere. So again, here's my little person, here's my horizon, here's my celestial sphere. But now, the North Celestial Pole is going to be on the zenith. And if I watch the stars, they're all going to just be circling around in the sky, following paths parallel to the horizon. So at the North Pole, none of the stars rise or set. They just circle around. In middle latitudes, it's going to be somewhere in between. So you're going to have some stars that circle, and that's going to be your circumpolar zone. And depending on how far north or south you are, you'll either have more stars circling than rise or set, or as you get closer and closer to the equator, you'll have fewer stars circling and more stars rising and setting. And we can picture all of that using the celestial sphere.